We are going to paint and build a free little library today. It is incredibly hot outside, but I decided today is the day. I have the instructions. I actually bought a little free library kit. It's the mini one from the Little Free Library website. I do hear thunder, so we're probably gonna get a storm soon. Definitely, what a great time I picked. Anyway, so these are all the pieces down here. That's the roof over there. And I'm going to go get white paint in order to paint it all. I also have the post thing here, which that's the top of the post. But this is everything that comes in, well, I should say this is everything that comes in the mini kit. And then I bought the post separately. It looks pretty easy to build. I don't know. I'm gonna have to find Alvin's drill, I guess. And I'm gonna have to paint it first. Well, I guess I'm going to go to the store and we're going to get outside. I decided I'm gonna paint it white. So I'm gonna do outside white paint. I've never built anything in my life, so this is gonna be fun. Alvin took my car to get inspected today. So we're driving Alvin's car.
At Lowe's. And also the storms are coming.
Got some paint, paintbrush, painter's tape. All right, we made it home in time. That's where the storm is over there. But I am going to put this together. I decided I'm gonna put it together and then paint it because that just seems like the easiest, the less mess, the less hassles. So let's see if we can put this together. At first I thought, oh, hey, Graham. At first I thought I picked a terrible day to do this because of the storm, but I think the storm is like just passing us, so it actually cooled everything down and gave a really nice breeze. So let's read how to build this. Front door, yes. Two side panels, which this one has the Little Free Library emblem on it, which is really cool. Which is this metal, black metal part, and this wooden part. These two side pieces, which are these smaller ones. Then they gave us the handle and some glue and some screws and stuff. Okay, so it says, note on finishing your library. We strongly recommend painting or staining both the inside and the outside of the library before installing it outdoors. So I am gonna build it and then I'll paint the inside and the outside. And then it says to use the wood glue because this increases the longevity. By adding glue to the short edge of the base, pressing it flush against the bottom edge of the side panel. Attach B and C using the 1 3/4 screws with a number 2 square drill bit and pre-drilled holes on the bottom side panel. Repeat on the other side. We've got our base here and this is the side, but I'm gonna do the wood glue. Okay, let's put this like this so that way we can have a surface here. Put the wood glue on. Put this on flush. Woo! Cool. This is literally the first time I've ever built anything in my life. Oh, we're dead already. We gotta take an intermission. I gotta charge this.
Okay, we are charging.
I am actually so proud of myself for just doing one screw so far. I've never built anything in my life, so. I am good at following directions, though. I am the direction queen. All right, I let it charge a little bit. We're back in business. Roof go the same way. Rotate the library so the long edges of the side panels are facing upward. All right, apply glue to the front edges of each side panel here. There we go. Okay, so now I use the 3-inch screws. Attach the back panel to the side panels and base. Rotate the library so the door A is face down panel here. So we're gonna put here like this. Nice. Wow. Look at this already. All right, attach the roof. Rotate the library upright and apply glue along the sides of the panels B. Position the roof E on top of the roof so the molding on the inside rests on the interior of the back panel D. So like this. Okay, so now we're applying glue to the top of here. It's on like this. And this goes on like this. Is that where the holes are? I think we use these black ones. Hex drill bit, yeah. All right, got a different bit here. So then this is gonna go in here. All right, how awesome does this look? It looks so awesome. Now I have to put these pieces on for the trim. So, here, yes, but I think it goes this way, and then this would go here. Whoops. There we go. We're gonna get it in here. Okay, another storm's coming. Doesn't exactly line up. That's probably my own fault. Oh well. This looks good if I do say so myself. All right, now we need to attach the door handle. So I guess we want to put this like kind of in the middle-ish. And then, all right, we gotta make sure that's not gonna be in the way. It's at about 2.5 inches up from the bottom. Paint it before I put the handle on though. This is what the library looks like so far. This is the inside. I did not put on the handle yet. I decided I'm probably gonna paint it first. I'm just gonna use this outside paint, and I got a paintbrush. I got some painter's tape so that way I can get in here. I guess I'll just have to be careful on the hinges and like this area here. I'm gonna try and paint the inside though, so I guess I'll do that first is the inside. And I'm kind of on a time crunch because, you know, we got a storm coming. But I made it this far. This is as handy as I've ever been in my whole life, so let's hope I don't ruin it with the paint. I
have to get a paint opener thing, so we're just gonna open it somehow. Oh yeah. See, common sense gets you really far in life, just to let you know. Also, my legs are killing me.
And you can see the rain coming, and I just started.
I should have spent the extra money on one of those nice angled brushes so I could get in the corners. What a nice atmosphere to paint in.
I put 2 coats on it. I am a mess. I ended up taking the door off and taking like all the hinges off and stuff. So everything has 2 coats. I made it through one storm. There's another one over there. And I'm gonna clean up and just let this dry. I'm going to take a shower and then I'm gonna put it all back together before I get electrocuted.
All right, it is the next day. I let my little free library dry all last night and most of today. It's like 1:30 in the afternoon. And then I did take the painter's tape off of the door. It doesn't seem like we had any bad craziness going on there. But now I need to screw all of the hardware back on, like all the hardware I took off. So I'm gonna work on doing that. Going to have to wait for Alvin's help, but the post, I don't know if I should paint it black or if I should stain it. I don't have any black paint, so I would have to go out and buy black paint. But I do think we might have some stain, and Alvin could probably do that for me because he stained some of our other stuff. So I'll have to see if that's something that Alvin wants to do. But I guess we'll put the post in the ground, and I think he said he was gonna even get some cement for it, and then maybe we could stain it while it's in the ground so that way it's like holding it up by itself. That might be the easiest. Cool. Now I need to put the handle on, which I think I said was gonna go down here. Ooh, there we go. That way it's easy to turn, but not so much that this is gonna flap open. I get to put up my little sign here at the top. I gotta make sure that's straight though. Not my OCD kicking in. Really? This is gonna be the hardest part? The stamp came in the mail. I'm so excited. That is so cute! Oh my gosh. That is adorable. This is such a cute little stamper too. I love this. These are books that my friends donated. I have this little like, call it almost like a glue stick, like a sticker adhesive thingy, adhesive roller. And I had my friends fill out these little like library cards. So that way when they donate a book, I'm actually gonna stick it to the inside page and then put the stamp. So that way any donations, like people know like who donated it, when they donated it, and if they liked the book, like why they liked it, why they think someone else should read it. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Handle with Care was donated by Lena from Lena's Bookshelf. And she said, I loved how this book made me wonder what I would do in this situation. I also love reading about how far a parent would go for their children. Check out my YouTube channel, Lena's Bookshelf. Super cute. So I'm gonna stick this in here like that. I wonder if I need to leave room for the stamp here. Oh, that's cute. Wow, that was really easy to stamp. There's the stamp, and then let's stick this in here. That is so adorable. How cute is that? All right, so the missing was donated by Jessie from Reading with Jess. So it says July 2022, donated by Jessie, her YouTube, her Instagram. And she says, I love this author because you can binge and this one will have island vibes. So that is really cute. I'm gonna stamp and put this in here. Cute. Oh no, I ran out of tape. Now I'm gonna have to go to the store and get more. All right, I'm also putting out some really cute bookmarks in this jar that's gonna go outside as well.
Those guys, he's taking the little free library down. Gosh, my windows are dirty. Aww. I was probably gonna try and get like some stones to put around it or something so it looks pretty-ish. Look how cute. I really love the stained post here. And I think we do have a motion sensor light that I might install in the top for when it's like winter time and it gets darker quicker. So far I just put in, these are the books that I have. I do have a few more coming from like the used books at second sale. And then I'm going to stick these little bookmarks out here. And technically it goes live tomorrow, so I'm gonna try and get some footage if people stop by. Okay, today is the official day that my little free library has gone live. I'm actually about to go hand these out to my neighbors. I just printed these off. This is something that the Little Free Library website gives you. There were three to a page, cut them in thirds, and then I just added my Little Free Library stamp at the bottom, so that way if they go to the mobile app, they could look at my charter number and be able to put it in there. I also printed this on cardstock, and then I kind of like laminated it just by taping it. I put like packing tape on it, and this I'm going to put inside my library somewhere. I don't know. I have this, maybe that would work. I also have some washi tape that I might be able to like use to keep it up. I've also found some more bookmarks. I'm gonna put these out there. I'm gonna put this take one on the jar of the bookmarks, and then I have this. I'm gonna set this in there as well. So it's like donating a book. You can use these library cards to say who donated it and write a little review. So I'm gonna put like this out here, like this inside. Some other things that I did to promote my library, I started its own Instagram account and its own Facebook page. And I went and took those links and I advertised them on my like local yard sale page. So if your area, maybe it's your neighborhood, has like a neighborhood page, ours doesn't. But I took like the yard sale page and I posted the photo of me and my library. And I was like, this is how a Little Free Library works. You know, I'm taking donations, it's open, you can come get a bookmark. And I have now, I think, over 100 followers, both on my Instagram and on my Facebook page. And I'm going to use those in order to keep everyone updated. So I'm going to do Mondays as my like restock. So every Monday, there will be a whole new restock of books. Thankfully, my library is small, so it only fits like, I would say about 8 books, because I wanna have some room for if people donate. So probably every week, I'll put a brand new 8 books out there and like swap and see what gets taken, what people like, you know, what genres they like. But then that way on my Facebook page and the Instagram page, I can post and be like, hey, like this is the setup for this week, or these are some new bookmarks I'm putting out there, or these are some new books that just came out. Or even if it's something that I read and I enjoyed and maybe I bought a copy for the Little Free Library, I could say, hey, I'm putting this out there because I just read it and this is my review and this is why I love it. Or when I'm doing holidays, like for instance, for Valentine's Day, I'm planning on doing a blind date with a book and like wrapping them all. For Christmas, I'm definitely gonna decorate the library and make it really, really cute and probably put like holiday reads in there specifically. For Halloween, I'm also going to probably decorate it in some spookiness, maybe put some jack-o'-lanterns at the bottom of it. And I'm also going to do like spooky books for Halloween. I could do green books for St. Patrick's Day. I definitely wanna make sure that I put diverse books in there for specific diverse holidays. So I do have some POC authors and some disability rep coming in the mail. I got some stuff off of second sale, and I'm currently building an order on Book Outlet as well, because they had some really good sales. And so I'm gonna be getting these hauls, but I don't think that they're gonna be part of this video because this might be getting too long. And so I'll probably just do a whole book haul video maybe with those. But you're gonna actually see more of Little Free Library vlogs, because anytime I get my library ready for a holiday or ready for something specific, I'm gonna do a video for it. So you guys will get to see like when I decorate it for Halloween and all that kind of stuff. It's gonna be so fun. All right, I'm gonna go out and put this stuff in there, and then I'm gonna walk around the neighborhood and hand these out, and hopefully people don't look at me really weird and they're like, oh my gosh, this is so great. This turned out pretty cute. So I have the take one, I have all the bookmarks in here, I have the donating a book, library cards, as well as the pen. And then these are just the books, so no one has actually gotten anything yet today. I do want to get a little magnetic light for the top, so that way at night they can see. And then for the sign, I just put it down here, but I don't know if it's gonna stick or not. I didn't really have anywhere else to put it because I didn't really want to put it on the glass, because then you can't see inside. So that might be, maybe I could get like a thumbtack.
Hi.
Hi.
I have a little free library. I live in the cul-de-sac.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a little birdhouse, but if you're a reader, there's books in there you can lend out, you can donate to it, whatever.
Okay.
But if you know of anyone that likes reading, you can tell them about it too. So.
Okay.
Hi.
Okay.
I live down on New Cameron at 281, and okay. I just built my own little free library.
Okay.
So I'm just handing these out so that way if you are a reader or know of anyone that's a reader, you can come check it out, grab books from it, donate books, whatever you'd like.
Okay.
So
very good.
And I'm Jackie, by the way.
Jackie,
nice
Sean.
To meet you.
Nice.
Have a good day. Oh, someone looked at my library. I didn't quite get it, but dog walkers. We got a book getter. Woo! Ah, I love seeing people getting books. It's so fun.
Okay, so we got a few donations. We have some kids' donations in here, but I'm going to take out, it's Monday, so I'm gonna take out all of the books, and I'm replenishing with some new ones that I got. Okay, this is what I replaced it with. So we have The Forest Meets the Stars, which was donated by my friend Corinna. And then this one I got because Jen had donated funds in order to get some books from POC Authors and Diversity. So I actually really wanna read this one. So I think I'm gonna get it from the library. This is a memoir. Then we have The Unhoneymooners. We have The Great Alone. And one of my favorite thrillers, The Last Mrs. Parrish, and then 28 Summers. And actually, like most of these, I just got off of second sale for like $4 or less, which was amazing. So definitely check out second sale if you're looking to stock your little free library. And then again, I just have my little bookmarks and the donating a book with the pen. And I have this down here. I don't know if I showed you guys this, but that is Monday's restock.
Okay, that's it. I think I'm gonna end this video here because you pretty much saw me build my whole entire little free library, stock it with books, got some footage of people taking books, but I will have more videos out, like when I get the little free library ready for a holiday, how I'm gonna do that, what decorations, like we'll do a whole decorate with me. And over these next few weeks, months, I will also be trying to get some footage of people, you know, like getting books out and stuff, because I think that's just cute and I can look back on it later. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If there's any questions that you had about the Little Free Library and about just how I did it, if I didn't cover that, just drop me a comment down below and I will answer them. But I will see you guys very soon in another video. Bye, everyone.